Hey there, welcome back to my mukbang. Today I have for you jjajangmyeon. I already opened the package up. This is a black bean noodle. I'm pretty sure it's Korean, if I'm not mistaken, because one of my favorite YouTubers has made this before, and another Korean YouTuber, there's actually two Korean YouTubers that has made this, so I'm guessing that it's Korean, I'm not very sure, but it's a black bean noodle, and they say it's delicious, and I actually made a homemade version of this, which is pretty hard to make, they say, and I want to see if it tastes like what I made. So here's the package of the sauce. I already cooked the noodles, and on the side here, I have sliced julienned carrot, julienned cucumber, and if I want to add some scallion, I will cut it into it. Seems like a lot of sauce for this little package of noodles. Ooh. Yeah, duh, I have a scissor here. So, how's everybody doing? I forgot to grab sugar because it's usually preferred to be sweeter. I wonder what these little itty bitty things inside here are. It's like chunks of something. I'm trying to read the ingredients in a minute, if they're even in, it should be in English. Mine did not taste like that. I don't know, mine might have tasted better. I don't know. It says there's cabbage, those chunks inside there. Cabbage, potato, and onion. Oh wait, that's soup. Yeah, soup base. Yeah, so. It's really dark. Okay. Then, oh my goodness. These noodles are thicker than ramen. They say that you could use some just regular thick spaghetti noodles to make this as well. Oh yeah, baby. Oh, and also they like to Koreans like to fry up their black bean sauce, even if it's from the package. You know, fry it up with some oil and add sugar, but I'm not gonna do that today. Okay, so that's what it looks like when it's all stirred up. Just gonna add some carrot. So the bowl doesn't look that pretty, but around with this black sauce all over it, but that's what it's supposed to look like. So, let's get into it. I've been wanting to eat this for the longest time. So, let's give it a go. That's potato. My husband is fixing the axles on our cars. It's called CV axles. Every time I go to eat ramen anymore, I want it to be spicy. A spicy noodle challenge. Those noodles are delicious. I am not doing good here. I'm almost ready to get a fork. Just that the noodles are so heavy. Goodness. It's good with the scallion. So, as of right now, we are carless. It looks kind of not so pleasing to the eye, but it's delicious. I must not be using the chopsticks correctly because I keep getting a cramp. I gotta make this mukbang fast because my husband's gonna need my help. He did the one axle on our Toyota Sienna 2004 on the driver's side. He's having a really hard time with the passenger side one. It's a lot more difficult. He had to buy a grinder, 4.5-inch grinder to try to saw off this piece that's in the transmission, because the bolts that are holding it together, they're just like, it's old, it's 2004. They rusted, and a lot of people on the internet are talking about that it's given them a really hard time. So this is what the last resort that they had to do was cut it in half, the, pipe. That's part of the axle. And then, I don't know how he's going to get that other part out. I thought that you need like a 20-pound press or something like that in order to get it out, which, you know, is only going to be at a shop. But apparently he's got it all figured out. I don't understand that terminology. I can to a certain extent. Like, because my dad, he even works on cars too. My husband doesn't do that for a living, but this is just, he's very handy. Saves us money.
love scallion. Okay, come on now. Don't even have a fork here. Every Asian that watches me is probably like, what is she doing? Now, there's times where I think I'm good at using chopsticks. Other times I'm like, I am an amateur. I think my 9-year-old daughter uses chopsticks better. These kids these days learn so fast. My 9-year-old daughter even likes sushi. She picks up the sushi roll, hand roll. Really good, to the point where the owner of a restaurant one time complimented her and said, wow, look at your chopstick skills. Like, and she caught on like right away to it too. Like staining them. The bowl looks like so messy. I love vegetables. That's why I think it would not be easy, but easier for me to transition, if I ever wanted to, into a vegan. The only thing with that that's difficult is the mentality of it, because I don't know if you watched one of my previous videos where I was talking about this topic, where I went vegetarian for a month. And during that period, like, I would go to eat dinner, right? And I would serve my family, like, the meat, right? And then alongside with the starch and a vegetable. Me, I only had starch and a vegetable, and it was like, there was always looked like there was something missing. And I was like, you know, like, I would think it would be difficult to get out of that mentality that the whole entree has to include meat. I don't know. I just, I just love the whole aspect of veganism and people trying to save the world and stuff. I'm like a hippie. Hello. I'm like a hippie as far as loving nature, animals, and trying to help the planet out as much as possible to, you know, my own household. The cucumbers and carrots are going bad in my fridge, so it's a good way to utilize them. Did you know that you could even fry up cucumbers? And it's delicious, when, you know, when you put, like Asian spice on it, you know, like ginger, soy sauce, sugar, garlic. Those are like the four main ingredients in Asian cooking. I hope my husband's not waiting for me. And he's probably like, where is she? Last of it. Wish I had some like kimchi or something with this. Sometimes I make my own kimchi. It comes out pretty good. Still have a good amount of cucumber left, but my kids like cucumber. It's like one of the only greens that they'll eat besides for like lettuce. My daughter likes broccoli, surprisingly. All right, well. Where are you going? Hope you guys enjoyed my mukbang. Don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, and I will see you on my next mukbang. Check you later.